I'm John Rybolt, a Vincentian priest. I've been at DePaul University off and on since about 1961 or 62. For several years, I was a member of the Board of Trustees, and now, since about 2003, I've been Vincentian Scholar in Residence, and my job is to put together the general history of the Vincentian community.
Can you tell us the story about the white tablecloth, what this represents in terms of the quality of care that Vincent suggests the Daughters of Charity ought to provide the people they're serving?
The phrase itself comes in the rules for the Confraternity of Charity that he founded in Châtillon, the first one in 1617. He wrote up rules for these charitable women in the parish, and the idea was that they would be able to come and take care of poor people in their parish who were in special need. There were always poor people, but how could they help them? One of the ways to help them, with especially the sick poor, was to go in and, as he said, greet them graciously, kindly. When they walked into the sick room, usually a couple of women went, and then talked to them about how things were going, how their life was going, and then when they gave them something to eat, they were to start by spreading out a white cloth, a white kind of napkin or little tablecloth on like a bed tray or a small table where the person could eat, giving them a certain level of dignity. They just didn't like distribute the food, throw it at them and leave, but they went there and they spread out this nice white cloth. We hope it was clean, I'm sure it was, and then helped them with their food, cutting it up if necessary, helping them to eat if they had to. But the thing that's so remarkable about this is that he would have thought to include a detail like that. Whether the detail comes from him originally or from some of the other women that he consulted about how to take care of poor people, I don't know. We'll never find that out. But he's the one who put the rules together, and he included this expression. And we hope that they did that finally. But if nothing else, it tells them about the quality of respect for the individual.
In the deliberation of the Conferences of Charity, which became the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, and the decision to use Vincent de Paul as the dominant sort of symbol or figure, a namesake, do you think there's a connection between this quality of care and the self-understanding of the early Society of St. Vincent de Paul?
Yes, the Society started about 200 years after the Confraternity started, so there was a great lag time there. The Society of St. Vincent de Paul was started in Paris by some young college students, basically, who wanted to do something charitable, but they didn't know exactly what to do. And one of the things that, again, I think was providential was that they were brought together with Sister Rosalie. Sister Rosalie was a very important Daughter of Charity. Important in the sense that from the quality of her work, not necessarily from the power that she had, but she was a great woman, and she said, if you don't know the poor, I can help you with the poor, and so let's go, and we're going to now go and minister to the poor. And I think that it was her sense about the care of the poor, whether she was quoting this document, that I doubt, but I think it was the same sense of respect and openness to poor people in their own homes that led Ozanam in his foundation of the society. St. Vincent, even in his own time, wanted his novices, the students in formation, to go out themselves every week and to greet the poor in their homes and to help them in the area right around where they were living. I suspect that, too, was formed by the same sense of dignity that had to be given to the poor people.